the Big Bang. We are back again at the Kung Fu Saloon, hanging out with Diamond Jim Tyler and, of course, of scamstuff.com, David Rowan. Now, this is an interesting one. David knows his stuff when it comes to magic, so I don't know exactly what we're in for here.
Let me see those thumbs. That's right. Okay. Continue.
All right, I do have something hidden in my hand, though.
Oh.
Safety pin, which you're welcome to examine. And a little do-rag here.
There you go. Done and done. All right.
So this is a great illusion. You're going to swear in just a moment. First, I'll have you hold on to this, get a grip on it. And so I'm going to put the safety pin where you say. I'm going to put it right through the handkerchief. You tell me when to stop.
When?
Right there. Take it straight through.
All right, now this is the part, if I was at home, I would be tempted to think like, oh, it's not really going through, but I could see fiber for fiber, it's definitely right through the middle.
And you can see we have, I don't know if you can see on the camera here, but we have a printed end of the handkerchief.
Yep, yep.
And then this part here that's not printed with a pattern, you can see it's definitely going through. No doubt about it.
Yep.
Right? And yet, watch this. Ooh. It moves straight through the cloth, no rip, no tear.
I love this.
Well done, sir.
It feels like, okay, there's some magic that speaks to you on an intellectual level. There's other magic that speaks to you on a visceral level. At a visceral level, it feels like, I think intellectually I'm on to what's going on, but at a visceral level, it feels like, no, wrong, it can't do that. Let's talk this through, but first you gotta give me a toast.
I actually like how you can see the path that the pin took, but there's no tear, right? So it's like...
Exactly, and sometimes if it's a quiet environment, they can actually hear what almost sounds like a rip in the cloth as the pin moves across.
As it rips space-time to arrive.
The fabric of space-time. So the nice thing also is the clumsiness of after it's moved to take it out, you have to push in
and let
take it all out and stuff. We've done very little stuff with safety pins, but I know that they're easier to open than you would think. And if I was gonna guess, tell me if I'm understanding this right, it has something to do with the fact that when you push, the mere pressure on this arm causes it to open enough that the fabric goes through. Can I just try it without knowing?
Yeah. You need tension on this cloth for this to work. There can't be any slack in it.
Okay, should it be my hands or, yeah, so if I do this.
Oh! Doesn't it sound like a rip?
It's almost better when you do it with yourself. Here, try. Go back the other way,
What do you do to get it to latch again once it's out?
It latches, it never unlatches.
It just
gets back unlatched enough. Here, if I did it slow motion, watch this. This is what's happening in slow motion. That's why it has to be all in one fast motion. I'll tell you what, I'll send it to you, and then you send it back. Ready, like one, two, three, magic.
Magic?
That
right?
does look like magic.
Did it look
From
like magic?
From this point of view, it
one,
looks
two,
like.
Magic?
Wow. Oh! 1, 2, 3, magic. Oh, that's fantastic.
Wow.
It really does feel like it's tearing through it. You get that brittle feeling. Okay, so in that case, I went too slow. So what do we know? We know that you've got to go fast and punctuated, that you need to maintain the tension, that you don't want it to be all hung up on there.
I think the biggest thing is that last part, getting it to clasp back together. Because the belief in the motion
That's
is...
why I'll try to do it as close to the top of the handkerchief as I can.
Okay.
I think if there's a lot of cloth in between, then it has a harder time.
Yeah.
Dude, what a great gem. Do you remember where you ran across this one?
It's in all the old magic books.
Yeah, no, there's nothing new under the sun when it comes to magic. That's amazing, though. All right, so you got a follow-up?
You introduce a second safety pin, two ordinary pins. You're welcome to, again, examine them, look at them.
Whatever someone says, two ordinary pins.
Yeah, I believe them instantly.
I'm saying that for the viewers.
Sure.
All right, I'm convinced.
Okay. So basically, I'm just going to close these and put these back in your hand. Take the two, and I want you to close your fist around them so you have the two pins. And do you know what telekinesis is?
Yes.
Power to move things with your mind. If you believe in telekinesis, raise my hand. Okay, it's not working. Okay, I'm going to try a little telekinesis on the pins. and you can feel the pins in your hand. Just loosen your grip a little bit. What I'm going to do is unlatch them in your hand. Do you feel that? You feel what's happening?
Wait. What just happened? Yeah,
I can feel them. I've got them open. As soon as I relax, it's like.
In your hand now, right? Yeah. So open your hand. You should have two open pins. Dump them on the table.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. I like that.
Okay, that's doubly good because it allowed me to think I knew where this was headed and then threw me a curveball. And it clearly, like that moment, you could see on your face when you felt something change.
That was surprise and delight. Is what
it's great
to call
because
it,
yeah. It's not a visual effect. It's something they actually feel happen in their hands.
So
you want to experience
setup?
It?
Yeah, I do. In fact, I'll not watch as you set it up because I don't want to even understand how it works.
Okay, so now close your hand around them.
Yep.
And you're going to feel them unpin themselves in your own hand as you.
I don't know if I'm grabbing it wrong. Oh! What just happened? That was very magical. Yeah. And they both opened. Oh, that's very good. Okay, what is the setup on that?
It's so simple. So all you do is when you close the pin, you put the wrong pin in the other pin.
So.
And it creates a lot of tension in the pins, like a spring. So now I'm pinching them closed. They want to force themselves open right now.
Got it.
So if I let go.
Then they do that. Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful.
They shoot far.
I've never seen this before.
This is brilliant.
So if you read the Bamboozler books.
Hey man, we just have them available at scamstuff.com. We save it for you.
You've got this weird, it looks like they're linked. But from this perspective, it just looks like two pins on top of one another.
You know what? Since people are probably suspecting that you're linking them, I wonder if you could lean into that and then say, let me put this in your hand. And you're like, on a scale of 1 to 10, how impressed would you be if they were linked? And instead you're like, I don't know, 5. You're like, what if they opened in your hand using telekinesis? And it's like, well, that'd be interesting. You're like, squeeze. So, oh, that would be fun.
Yeah.
So okay, here, can I try it?
You want to try it, please?
Yeah, okay, so you get the two of them side by side. David Rowan.
What's up, man?
Hold out your hand, good sir. There we go. There you go. All right, I'm going to put that in there. All right, squeeze tight.
Yep.
And now relax.
There we go.
Well,
this is even better, because sometimes it's different.
Well,
sometimes they kind of like open up in multiple dimensions.
Mm-hmm. Like, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like instead of just this way, it goes this way too.
This is my favorite kind of magic, stuff that involves senses besides sight, where it's this kinesthetic sense that you get. What a great one. Diamond Jim Tyler.
Thank
you enough. I should read the Bamboozler series.
What's that, volume two?
One, two, somewhere in there.
I'm only off by one.